DaVinci Resolve 18 is out of beta and finally production ready. So in this video, we're going to cover some of the most exciting features included in version 18, plus a deeper dive into two game changers, the surface tracker and the depth map tool, both used natively inside the Fusion page. And if you need any help on how to download and install this update, I recommend that you check this video by Mr. Alex Tech. Now, you must know that some of those features are powered by the Neural Engine, which is exclusive to the studio version of DaVinci Resolve. And what a timely coincidence that Blackmagic Design contacted us because they were impressed by our channel and offered to support us by providing a studio license code to give away to one of our followers. So if you're interested to learn more about it, stay with us until the end, get comfortable, and let's get started. Going over every new features would take way too much time, and most of you will get bored halfway anyway. So we made a short selection of our favorite tools. The Object Mask is a smart tool using the Neural Engine to recognize and automatically track a variety of elements like objects or animals. This is an extension of the Magic Mask. And while it is only available inside the color page and is primarily designed for color grading, you can definitely use it to quickly create some fun effects for your videos. The Ultra Beauty tool has been updated and is available inside the Edit, Color, and Fusion pages. This tool is very useful to smooth out textures and recover details on someone's face. Compositors will be happy to learn that the Paint tool is now GPU accelerated, which means that at last we can see our brushstrokes in real time. This will make retouching work a lot more intuitive and precise. Blackmagic Cloud is a big one. Imagine being able to collaborate with other creatives all around the world in a seamless fashion. And instead of building your project library locally on a private network, it is stored on Blackmagic Cloud servers. There is a $5 monthly fee to host a project library, which lets you invite up to 10 people to collaborate on a project or even the same timeline. You can then very easily review and accept changes that have been made by others without the need of tedious reconfirming. The Proxy generator is a great addition to anyone looking to optimize their workflow. This app comes with DaVinci Resolve and automatically generates lighter proxies whenever you add media files to one or multiple watch folders. A common scenario: you are a creator and regularly you need to share your footage with another editor, either locally or via cloud drive. All you have to do is to set the proxy format, import your clips inside the watch folder, and extract those proxies to a cloud shared folder. That's it. Maybe the most exciting addition to this update is the surface tracker. And while this is not a tutorial, but rather a breakdown of the tool, you should be able to connect the dot and make it work on your side. Well, we will have, of course, an in-depth tutorial coming soon to the channel. This new tracker is capable to track a warping surface and apply over it an image in a realistic way that cannot be achieved with a planar tracker. And while we normally use a powerful and feature-rich software like Mocha Pro for those complex tasks, we can now do simpler job right inside the Fusion page for a much faster workflow. Here's a sequence with Blue walking in the forest and how we use the surface tracker to composite a tattoo onto her chest. And while this is a quick and dirty job, the tattoo is nicely warping over her skin, and I believe that the result is good enough for most projects. Now, let's see how this is working. You start by defining the boundaries of the surface that will be tracked. You can add as many as you need and even create holes to ignore elements that sit within those boundaries. Then, inside the mesh page, you can limit tracking to a certain frame range and how the points forming the mesh will be located. In this case, and because of the type of texture I wanted to track, I went for uniform grid and adjusted the spacing. Onto the track page, this is where you will set the tracking behavior like motion range, mesh rigidity, and tracking quality, which means how precise and resource intensive the tracking will be. The top part is all about controlling the tracking operations, like tracking direction or removing existing tracking data. Once the tracking is done, the result page is where the real fun begins. You can choose the type of output. Here, it is set to warp the image of the tattoo onto the main image source. You have a bunch of controls letting you place and adjust the overlay. And finally, the composite type, which is the blending mode. It is set to overlay to blend the tattoo naturally with the underlying surface. This is all great, but as you can imagine, it didn't magically composite the tattoo underneath the clothing. For this, I used a mix of traditional rotoscoping for the t-shirt and a more creative solution for the vest, where I actually use two separate surface trackers as masking tools. Same principle as for the tattoo, but instead of applying a texture, I am outputting those meshes as alpha mask for the main tracker. When you think about how much time rotoscoping can take, this is pretty damn cool. The depth map tool is another neural engine power feature that can analyze a clip and generate a map that can be used for color grading or applying effects to a specific range. This is very much like what modern phones are using to separate the subject from the background and apply various effects like a depth blur. And for this example, this is exactly what I did, by quickly isolating blue to apply some trippy effect to the background. This is a much simpler tool, but it can take some fidgeting to get the result that you're looking for. Once again, you can set the quality or level of precision. There is an option to display or not a preview of the effect, and another one to invert the depth map to isolate the foreground instead of the background. If the automatic mapping isn't accurate enough, you can go full manual and adjust yourself the mapping levels by setting a far and near limit. You can also use the isolation controls to further narrow down the depth that you want to target. Finally, the post-processing option lets you apply a post filter to add some finesse to the depth map at the cost of extra computing power. Once the map is ready, you can very easily use it with any tool by setting its channel to luminance. This way, the effect will be applied to the image depending on how bright is the map. The brighter, the stronger. Are you excited by the potential that those tools could be bringing to your toolset? If the answer is yes, here's your chance to win a license of DaVinci Resolve Studio. It is simple and won't take much effort. Make sure that you are subscribed to our channel and to follow us on Twitter, because this is a great platform to stay in touch with you guys. Last, post a comment on this video telling us which feature in version 18 is your favorite, so we can pick a random winner. I hope you enjoyed this video and that you got inspired to create some wicked stuff. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video. See ya!